जय हिंद माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स। बार ग्राफ एंड डबल बार ग्राफ, लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड बार ग्राफ विद एन एग्जांपल। इन बार ग्राफ द डेटा इज रिप्रेजेंटेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ बार्स एंड यूनिफॉर्म विड्थ। ड्रॉ हॉरिजॉन्टली एंड वर्टिकली विद इक्वल स्पेस बिटवीन दम। Length of bars in proportional to the data. Let's represent the following data using bar graph. To represent this data graphically, first of all, we will draw a horizontally line and a vertical line as shown. Then we write categories such as red, white, blue, gray and purple on horizontal axis. Number of caps sold on vertical axis. Then we will choose appropriate scale. That is, we will specify how many caps will be represented by a unit length of bars. Here we will choose one unit 10 caps. Accordingly, we will write the number of caps sold vertical axis. Now we will find the height of the bar as per the data. Here 20 caps sold. To represent the number 20, we can to draw the bar extending to 0 to 20 on vertical axis. It will be a bar of height 2 unit. Similarly, to represent 45 caps, we draw a bar extending from 0 to 45 on vertical axis. Here note that any two division have 10 subdivision. So 45 will be represented as 4.5. This way we can represent all the data on the bar graph. By looking a bar graph, can you tell which kind of cap sold the least? Here the bar with the small height will be an answer. Purple caps sold least. So what is the difference between the red cap and the blue cap sold from the shop? We can see that the height of bars differ by half unit. Since one unit represent 10 caps, so half unit represent 10 by 2, half, 5 caps. Now let's understand about double bar graph. Following table shows the number of ice cream sold by seller A on Sunday and seller B on Sunday. To draw a double bar graph, observe this value. Lowest value 35, highest value 52. Range of this data 35 to 52. Next, choose appropriate value. If choose the scale 1 unit 1 ice cream, the bars will be very tall, so could not represent a paper. Choose a large value 1 unit 50 ice cream, it will be difficult to represent 35. So choose 1 unit 5 ice cream or 1 unit 10 ice cream. Can you choose 13 here? No, given value not a multiple of 13. So they cannot easily represent. We cannot take 13 as unit length. We will choose one unit 10 ice cream. Now here we have to draw two bars, so we must differentiate them. Red bars, number of ice cream sold by seller A. Blue bar, number of ice cream sold by seller B. Okay, draw the double bar graph. First draw vertical and horizontal axis. Show the categories like strawberry, vanilla, chocolate, etc. horizontal axis. And the number of ice cream sold on vertical axis. Celery sold 40 ice creams. So draw bar 0 to 40 by red color. 40 to vanilla ice cream. 42 is between 40 and 50. So each unit 10 ice cream. 10 part of unit bar represent ice cream is 1 ice cream. 10 part of unit represent 1 ice cream. 42, so represent, we have to represent out of 2 parts, out of 10 divisions. So extending from 0 to 42. In the same way, we will finish the double bar graph. Shall we do the problems on exercise 3.3? Listen the question. Number of children in 6 different classes are given below. Represent the data on a bar graph. Given the class 6 to 10, the number of children 6th 135, 6th 5th 135, 6th 120, 7th 95, 8th 100, 9th 90, 10th 80. Then given 2 sub question, which class has the maximum number of children and the minimum? Second, find the ratio of the student of class 6th to the student of class 8th. So we want to draw a bar graph. First we draw a horizontal line. A horizontal line and a vertical line. Horizontal line and a vertical line. This horizontal axis, horizontal line is known as x axis. Vertical line is called y axis. Horizontal line and vertical line intersecting this point as origin, denoted as O. X axis and Y axis intersect origin, that portion, that is denoted as O. Then we know the bar graph is a pictorial representation of numerical data in the form of rectangular bars of equal width and varying height. So equal width we want. So here the x axis represented as class, different class, and y axis represented as number of children. Given the data, number of children. Then choose the appropriate scale. So here smaller number of children is 80, greater number of children is 135. So we can take the small division, small unit. This is 1 square, this is take as 1 unit. So scale division on y axis take as 1 unit. See, we can take we want to represent 135 height bar, so take easy to represent 10 students. 1 unit take us 10 students, 10 children. Okay, so here this 1 square, 1 unit represents 10. That means this small division is represent 1 unit. 1 children, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So again 1 unit, 20, then 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110,
120, 130, greater value 135, so one more division 140. Okay, then we know the bars keeping equal space between them, so leave this one unit, start here. So this bar is, this space take us fifth class, then leave this one unit, then this is sixth class, then leave this one unit, this is seventh class, leave this gap, and this is eighth class, and leave this, this is ninth, leave this, this is tenth class. Okay, then we represent the height of fifth standard 135. 135 we want to draw extending the rectangular bar 0 to 135. So 0 to here 130, take 5 more division, small division, this is 135, draw the rectangle. Rectangle bar. So take this here 135 number of children. Then leave this gap. Then 6th is 120. 120, 0 to 0 to 0 to 120. So this is the point. So 0 to 120 extending bar. This is 120, then 7th standard 95, 95 is 0 to 90 here, then 95, 5 more small division here, 95, number of children 95. Then 8th standard 100, 100, 0 to 100 is here, 100, 0 to 100 portion. Okay, draw the rectangular bars. Then next is 9th class 90. 90 is the position here. 0 to 90. 90. Draw the bar. Okay, this is 90. Then 10th class 80, leave this gap, 80, 80 is 0 to 80, this position, so this is 80 number of students. Then listen, which class has the maximum number of children? So here maximum number of children, which class the maximum height of bars is? Yes, fifth standard, so fifth class. Then second question is, and the minimum. So minimum number of children in minimum height. least height is in which class? Yes, 80, 10th standard. Okay, so 10th class. Listen this question, second question. Find the ratio of the students of class 6th to the student of class 8th. So 6th standard, how many students? 120. So ratio represent this is 2. Is 2 sign. This is 2 sign ratio. Then 120 is 2. 8th standard. 8th standard 100. Okay. We can reduce this ratio. 120 by 100. We can cancel this 0. Then 12 and 10. 12 into times 6, 10 5 times. So we can reduce, the ratio is equal to 6 is to 5. Okay, understood all of you? Listen this question. The performance of a student in first term and the second term is given. Draw a double bar graph. Given the subject, English, Hindi, Maths, Social Science and Science. First term mark and second term mark. Then given three sub-questions. Listen, the first term marks 67, 72, 88, 73, 81. The least mark is, yes, 72 mark. Higher mark 81. Then here, the least mark is, second aim, least mark is 70. Higher, greater mark is 85. Then we want to draw the double bar graph. So first draw a horizontal line, that is x axis. Horizontal line and vertical line. Horizontal line is, yes, 9 meters, x-axis, x-axis. This is O, then vertical line is y axis. Then we represent x axis subject. So we want equal gap in between bars. So this leave one bar. Then write subject English. Then leave this bar. Next write Hindi. Then leave this bar. Next write Maths. Leave this bar. Next bar is social science. Leave this bar. Next bar is science. Okay. That means x axis represented as subject. Then y axis represent the marks. Marks. So we can take first is choose the appropriate scale. So scale division on y axis 1 unit. See, first term least mark 72. Second time least mark 70, higher mark 88 first time, 95 second time. So we can take 1 unit, easy to represent 1 unit, 10 marks or 5 marks. So we can take this 10 marks. Okay, so this one square, this square is represent one square, one side is, this side is 10 marks. That means the small division, this is 1 mark, 2 mark, 3 mark, 4 mark. Small dark green line, this is 5 mark. Then 6 mark, 7 mark, 8 mark, 9 mark, 10 mark. So each part is 1 mark, represent 1 mark. Okay, so take this mark, OE axis, 10 mark, 20 mark, 30, 40, then 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 100. Okay, then we want to represent here two bars, double bar graph. So we differentiate two bars. First, one bar is one square bar, non-shaded bar represent the first 10 mark. Okay, understood? Then shaded, this model shaded bar is represent second 10 mark. Okay, then draw the bars. First time, English first time, 67 marks. That is non-shaded bar. So draw the rectangular bars. Listen, we want to draw double bar graph. So divide this one unit into equal portion. This small dark green line divided two equal portion. One bar is divided into two equal portion. Okay. So 67 mark first term, 0 to 60, 60 mark, then small one division, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67 is here. Okay, then draw rectangular bar. Half portion take us one bar. Okay, this is 67 mark first time. Then second time 70 mark. Okay, so 70 marks is where the position 0 to 70 here. Okay, second bar. Okay, then to identify, draw shaded mark. Okay, so this is represent 70 mark, second day mark. Okay, then this equal gap and Hindi 72 marks. So 0 to 70 here, then 72, 71 small division. Second small division is 72. Mark it. Then draw the rectangular bar. Okay, this is 72 marks. 72 marks. Then second time Hindi is 65 mark. 65 marks we can represent it as 0 to 65. 65 is here. 60, 0 to 60. 60 here. Then 61, 62, 64, 65 here. So draw second bar. Then shading to represent second time Hindi mark. So this mark is 65 mark. Okay. Then equal space and max. Max 88. So 0 to, this is 0 position. 0 to 88. 8 is here. Then this small division, this is 85. 86, 87, 88 is there. Okay, draw one bar. Non-shaded bar is represent the first time mark. So this is 88 mark. Okay, then second time 95 mark. 90 is here. 90 mark here. Then 95 is this position. Okay. After 5 small division. Okay. Then draw the shaded bar that is represent the second day mark. Okay, draw the shader. This is 95 marks. Then social science. Social science 73. 0 to 70 here. Then 73 small 3 division. 71, 72, 73. Draw the bar. Okay, 73 marks. Next is second time 75. 75 marks is here. See, 0 to 70, 73 here, 74, 75 after 2 division. Okay, shade this region to represent the second day mark. Okay, that is 75. Next, last subject, science. Science 81, 0 to 80, yes, 80 here, 0 to 80. Then we want 81, one small division. Okay. First time science mark 81. Then second time is 85. 85 is where? 0 to 81 is here. Then 82, 83, 84, 85. Okay. Draw the shaded bar represent second day. Okay, so graph is over, double bar graph. Next, listen this question. In which subject has the child improved his performance the most? So the child improved his performance the most. We can identify this graph, the maximum height of bar improved most. So maximum height of the bar is 95 marks got. Which subject? Maths. So in mathematics, child improved his performance most. So answer is yes. Which subject? Mathematics. Okay, then next question is that in which subject is the improvement the least? The least height which subjects? In which subjects is improvement the least? Least. English. 70 marks, then Hindi 65 marks. Social science 75. So we can write as child to show improvement in English, mathematics. English 67 mark to improve 70 mark. Then maths 88 mark improvement to 95 marks. Social science 73 improved 2 marks, 75. Then 81 marks. So science then improved 4 marks. That is 85 marks. So child show improvement in. Child show improvement in. Which are the subjects? English. See, English. Then, yes, maths. Then this mark is 75. So, social science and science. Okay. Then next question. Next third question, listen. Has the performance gone down in any subject? Listen this bar. Yes, this bar is to move upward, but this bar is downwards. 72. This is 65. That means the performance go down. Which subject? Hindi. So answer Hindi.
Chance and probability. In our day-to-day life, we often across many statements, out of which some are sure to happen, some are impossible, and whereas some may or may not happen. Let us consider some statements. The sun setting in the east. This is impossible because the sun rises in the east. Increases in the side of a square result in the increases in its area. This is sure because of the area of the square is side into side. Tomorrow will be a bright sunny day. It depends on the sun. So, may or may not happen. Fourth, father is younger than his son. This is impossible because father is always elder than his son. A leap year consists of 366 days. This is sure to happen. On tossing a coin, I will get hit. This is may or may not happen because a coin is tossed. There are two possible outcomes, head or tail. On throwing a die, I will get the number 6. A die has 6 faces, that is numbers 1 to 6. Hence, this may or may not happen. From this statement, we can understand some statements are sure. Some are impossible, some are may or may not be happen. Okay. For example, when we toss a coin, it has two possible outcomes, either head or tail. Sometimes we get predicted, have some, sometimes come predicted fault. Listen this activity. Take a coin, toss it 20 times, record the observed as shown in the table. Head represent H, tail represent T. From the table, we can observe that number no fixed pattern for occurs head and tail. It is the chance to get either head or tail. This means total number of outcomes 2. head and tail. Favorable outcomes: 1. Head or tail. Probability of getting head: 1 by 2. Number of favorable outcome: 1 by 2. Now, probability of getting tail, same as 1 by 2. From this table, total number of head is 12, total number of tail is 8. So, probability of getting head is 12 by 20, that is equal 3 by 5. Probability of getting tail is 8 by 20, that is equal 2 by 5. If we on increasing the number observed, we find that probability of getting head and probability of getting tail as 1 by 2. Let us learn about some fact regarding probability. The event sure to happen, 1. The events no chance of happening, 0. And the events having many possibilities between 0 and 1. That means 0 less than, probability less than 1. Now, if a die is thrown, the probability of getting outcomes, result 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. There are 6 possible outcomes. So, the probability of getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. So, the probability of each outcome we get 1 by 6. Okay, listen the exercise 3.4 questions. There are 6 marbles in a box with the numbers from 1 to 6 marked each of them. What is the probability of drawing a marble with the number 2? Second sub question, what is the probability of drawing a marble with the number 5? Listen, 6 marbles in a box with the numbers 1 to 6. So this is 1 marble, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 marbles in a box. The first question is, what is the probability of drawing a marble with the number 2? Here, how many total number of marbles? Total number of marbles is 6 marbles. We want to take only one marble, that marble is number 2. So, number 2, only one marble. So, probability, we know the formula, probability of getting an even equal. Probability of getting an event equal number of getting favorable outcome, number of getting favorable outcome divided by total number of outcome. Okay, so here number of getting, probability of getting or probability of drawing a marble with the number 2 equal number of getting number 2 marble, only one marble, by total number of outcome. Here how many total number of marble? 6 marbles. So answer is 1 by 6. Okay. Second question, what is the probability of drawing a marble with the number 5? So probability of drawing a marble with the number 5 equal number of drawing a marble with the number 5, yes, only one marble, by total number of marble 6. So answer is 1 by 6. Okay, listen the next question.
A coin is flipped to decide which team starts the game. So we throwing a coin, we get tossing a coin, we get two outcome. Outcome means what? Outcome means yes, a result. Okay. So tossing a coin, we get two outcome. That is, one is head and second is tail. Only how many outcome? Two outcomes. Okay. The question is, what is the probability that your team will start? You can select any one outcome, head or tail. So total number of outcome is two outcome, but number of getting favorable outcome is only one time. So your team will start, probability of that your team will start, team will start equal number of favorable outcome. You can choose head or tail only one times, one by one outcome by total number of outcome is two. That is, answer is 1/2. Okay, understood all of you?
Your homework question, exercise 3.3, 5th and 6th question, exercise 3.4, 1st question. Okay, students, we have finished this chapter. I hope all of you understood all the problems related to this chapter. If you have any doubt, please refer to me. Write the relevant points and exercise question in the notebook. Thank you.